An important factor to keep in mind when designing with 80/20 is add-on components to incorporate motion, pressurized substances, or stanchions. 80/20 offers solutions for many projects, but let's first take a look at the type of motion components. There are two main types, linear bearings and dynamic pivots. Linear bearings are more commonly used for transporting materials in a repeated motion in an application. 80/20 offers standard and high cycle pads for linear bearings. High cycle pads have a special threaded insert designed for sudden acceleration and deceleration without deteriorating. Unibearings are also available, which differ from traditional bearings in that they're adjustable for a range of profiles and can be installed even when the T-slot profile is captivated. Dynamic pivots are designed to provide axial motion, ranging from 0 to 180 degrees, and act as a high-strength pivot point. Now that we've briefly reviewed 80/20 solutions, let's look at some key considerations: load capacity, load type, and speed. First up, load capacity. Linear bearings are not intended to support excessive amounts of weight. However, they're a great choice for projects like machine fixtures or chop saws. Dynamic pivots, on the other hand, are better equipped to handle heavier load capacities. Now let's look at load type. 80/20 linear bearings are designed to support compression loads only. They're not intended to support hanging loads to function properly and safely. Dynamic pivots move in an axial motion, but are not recommended for cantilevered loads. The final factors to look at are speed and frequency of use. Linear bearings are equipped to handle transporting materials repeatedly, but usually at a slower pace. Dynamic pivots create a high-strength pivot point and are then able to handle higher frequency and higher speed loads. There are also options to include a locking handle to lock into a 90 and 180 degree position. Along with motion components, 80/20 also offers other add-on components, such as pressure manifolds and stanchions. Pressure manifolds allow you to add a pressurized substance, such as liquids or air, into the center cavity of a T-slot profile. 80/20 offers a range of access, feed, and stopper plates to suit your structure. An example of a manifold configuration could include an access plate attached to the supply line and a feed plate mounted where the pressurized substance is released. The stopper plate secures the profile end to form a tight seal. As for stanchions, they're used to create an additional axis by using 80/20 aluminum tubes. There are a variety of vertical and horizontal bases to allow for additional axes. Now that we've explored the main considerations for choosing your add-on components, are you ready to start designing? We hope you found this segment about add-on components helpful. For more information, please visit 80/20.net. When you subscribe to our channel, you can expect to see more inspiration for your future projects.